zero, small brush, and then probably you can have two, brush number two, number four, and number six, but I will just use brush number probably four. Okay, so I'm gonna put all these brushes aside, and what I have in the palette is a black, yellow ochre, mid yellow, lemon yellow, mid green, and white. So I'm gonna mix a bit of the color first. Acrylic, we like to create layers. So for the trees, we paint from the darkest tone to the lightest tone, depending on where the sunlight comes from. I'm gonna mix a few of the shades here, so you can know what type of colors of the shading that I will use later. First of all, we just take the mid green and mix with the black and mix with a little bit of yellow ochre, and this will become our darker shade. If you think that the shade is not dark enough, then keep adding the black and you can have a darker shade. So now I just take the darker shade, use this mid green mix with my mid yellow, and now you have a brighter shade. But what I want is to add a little bit of yellow ochre so the color can be a little bit more earthy. And then now I need a much lighter shade, so I'm gonna wash my brush and I'm gonna mix a lighter shade. Take this color in lemon yellow and mix it together, and this is our much brighter shade. Some of the leaves to be maybe not so vibrant, already turn yellow and want to fall, so you can actually create another shade, which is with the white, and you take a little bit of yellow ochre and you mix with your green, and this could be the sunlight. If you need a little bit of yellow, you can definitely mix some yellow. It depends on what kind of the color of the trees that you want. So I want to share with you how to mix brown for the tree trunk, because most of the people, when you buy the set, you may have the brown, but some of you may not have the brown. So I need another color, which is the red. So I just put a little bit more red here. Later I'm gonna mix the tree trunk so you can see. So let's paint the first tree. You can see something like a Christmas tree. So a lot of people actually like this tree, so I'm gonna do a little bit more of this shade. It's 1, 2, 3, and then you mix this color. So use a flat brush. Stop here so you can see it properly, see clearer. Okay, so how should we do? So the Christmas tree has the straight line, but we don't really need to draw the straight line. So either way you can draw the straight line, and then you go left and right, see, from small to big, left and right, left and right. Paint this shade first. You can see, basically, I'm just going left and right and making the shades a little bit like a triangle. So you still go left and right and left and right. But right now, I want my sun to shine from this end, so at the bottom it will be a little bit darker. So I take this shade and mix with a little bit of black, and this will be the shadow of the tree, more closer to the ground. And then you don't need to wash your brush, just take the second shade of the green, and then you go on top, just go one side where the sun is shining. So go more towards on this side, because want to make this sun brighter, so I take a third shade and then I go a little bit on top. Okay, this seems to be a little bit more too bright, so doesn't matter. I'm gonna darken this side again. Depends on how bright you want a tree to be. If the sunlight is going very strong and you want to create a more vibrant or a more obvious tree, you can definitely put more green. So now I just take my yellow and put on top where the sun is shining over here. So I just put on top a little bit more towards here. For the lower part, take the darker shades of the green. Okay, for the ground, on top here, we want a little bit more. So, a lot of beginners doesn't really know how to use the fan brush, but once you use the fan brush, you will actually like using the fan brush. But since most of the set doesn't carry the fan brush, I'm just going to share how to paint a tree using a flat brush. You can also do using a flat brush. So in this manner, you see, you have layers. You have layers of the darker shades at the bottom and then the lighter shades on top. And now I want to do the ground. So ground, brown color, take the yellow, take the green, and mix with the white, and mix with the red. Green and red will become brown. Okay, I just want a little bit more for the yellow ochre. So I just mix with yellow ochre and I get the color of the soil. First Christmas tree, and then now I want another type of tree. I just take the brush number 0 and I want to do the tree branch. So I'm going to take the green mix with the red and you will get brown. Always remember how to get brown Christmas color. So red and the green, equal amount of the red and the green will give you brown. So when you draw the tree branch, always draw the main branch first, downwards. Main branch will be the most thickest. So after the main branch, you can actually branch out to the second branch, and then you branch out to the third branch. Take my flat brush again, and again we're going to take the black, the yellow ochre, the black yellow ochre and the mid green and mix together, and this is our darker shade. So go with the bottom of the tree where the sun will not shine. So go left and right. So this tree, I want it to be a little bit like the round shape. So you go a little bit round, and then sometimes you can go like this. Hold your brush this way or this way. So use the edge. Use the edge of the brush to paint. This type of tree, you will need to use the edge. This type of tree, you go left and right, and this type of tree, you go something like this. It's a circular manner. to paint fast so you can see how this works. I hope you can see clearly. If you can't, please let me know. So, and then I take the second shades of my green and I go on top, and this time the sun is shining from this angle, so this part will be lighter. Take the second shades. I go a little bit more on this side. Sometimes you don't really need to fill in the trees with leaves. It's very heavy, it's very intense. I don't normally fill in all. And then now you take the second, the third shade. So how to get the third shade? You take the lemon yellow mixed with the yellow ochre. Lemon yellow, take more, and then take the yellow ochre. Okay. And now you will have a lighter shade. So I want it to be a little bit more on this side. This side, I want it to be a little bit more yellow. Take the yellow ochre mixed with white. A little bit of yellow. Inside here, I want it darker, so I'm going to take the black, the yellow ochre, and the green, and get a darker shade. I want the underneath the tree to have a little bit of shadow, so I just touch up using the darker shades. Three branches, so I'm going to mix the Christmas color again, red and green to get brown. And now you can touch up. This is my second tree, and then the third one, it's similar, but it's just the tree is growing outwards. So I'm gonna draw my tree branch first. Again, tree branch, brown, mix these two colors together, you'll get brown. And we always draw the main tree branch first. This time, the tree is growing outwards. So draw the second branch, and then the third one, and then the fourth one. small place, so I'm going to grow the tree slightly shorter. So you can see, wow, I have a lot of tree branches. And I take the same flat brush. And again, we go with the darker shade, black, yellow ochre, and mid green. Now this time the sun is shining from this side, so I'm gonna push this a bit higher so you can see. So the sun is shining from this angle, so I want this side to be brighter and this side to be darker. So again, use the side of your brush to dab the leaves. Okay? Both sides of the brush you can use. Then I take the second shade and I add it on to this side. Brighter on this side, so I take the third shade of the green. So this is one cluster of the leaves, and then another cluster of the leaves here. Grow it lower. Now let's do the third shade, the leaves. Okay, take the yellow ochre, take the lemon yellow, and take the white. Then you can add a little bit on top here where the sun is shining. Take a little bit of your lemon yellow and mix a little bit with white. If you want the contrast to be a little bit more obvious, then you can definitely add white and make it a little bit more contrast and more layer. So below here, I want it to be a little bit dark. So again, I want the dark shades. So I mix with my black, yellow ochre, and my green. That is the darker shade that I'm using. Okay. We'll go a little bit darker on this side so the contrast can be a little bit more obvious. So some of this leaves be a little bit darker. Okay, right now I'm gonna do my tree branch again, Christmas color again, red and green, mid green, you get a Christmas color. The reason why I need to keep mixing the color is because the acrylic dries very fast, so if you're not going to paint fast, then don't put a lot of colors on your palette, otherwise it will dry very fast. So here I add a little bit more tree branches. three type of tree, we definitely use the black at the bottom that casts the shadow. At the back, the black, the darker shades to cast the shadow, and then when the light is shining from this end, this side of the tree will be brighter. The sun is shining from this end, that's why this side of the trees are brighter, as well as this one. The sun is coming from this side, the tree on this side will be brighter. Okay, the reason why I want to share how to paint a tree is because I have a request from one of the customers to do how to paint a tree. So I think it's a good idea. After we paint a tree tomorrow, I'll paint another maybe three or four types of tree, and then after that we can do sunset, a series of sunset, because basically this is a daylight tree, and the sunset trees will be black or dark brown, but the techniques is the same. Do you have any questions so far? Liking the demonstration. I see you tomorrow again.